You know, there have been so many films now that have involved you, you know, Bombshell, Loudest Voice in the Room, and these different documentaries. And like we're talking, I noticed no one's clamoring for the rights to Weinstein. What is it like to see your story being told and you not being able to, because of respecting, honoring contracts, have input? How hard is that?
Well, I don't have an NDA with Fox, so I can say what I want.
No, then dish.
But it's, I guess it's just surreal. You know, like when I watched Bombshell, what was clear to me was they had just taken my book and maybe Janice Dean's book and put it on the big screen without paying anybody any rights, right? And they sprinkled in enough things that they thought made me look bad that they would have street cred, you know, with the people who don't like me.
Right.
So, I mean, but they didn't claim it was a documentary. You know, they admitted that it was a drama that was based on a true story. And so it was bizarre. I mean, I'll tell you just one story about it.
Yeah.
Last summer, I guess it was last summer, I had nothing to do with Bombshell. And I didn't even know it was called Bombshell. And I was at, we have a house on the Jersey Shore, and I'm in Jersey, baby. And my phone starts lighting up, like boom, 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 boom. And what is it? It's like every friend I know who sent me the Bombshell trailer that had just hit. And so I look at it, I recognize this must be what they're calling the movie. And there I am, you know, it's me. It looks just like me.
Yeah.
And
yeah,
there's an elevator with colleagues I used to work with going up to Roger Ailes' office, which does bring back a lot for me. And Stephen, can I tell you, I burst out into tears. I burst out into tears. I was just like, it brought back so much in that moment.
Yeah.
It's like seeing yourself in one of the darkest periods of your life. It's you, you know, because yeah, she looks so much like me. And it was upsetting. It was just emotionally triggering, even though I hate that term. So the whole thing was emotional.
Term.
I'm glad it's in the rear view. You know, I think the movie did some good because it shined a light on the problem. But I'm glad it's over.
How funny would it have been if you broke into tears and said, they call me a bombshell? Because it could have been worse.
I wish that were the meaning of it. I don't think that was the meaning.
That's how I would interpret it. But in my case, it would be called bag of shit. So, yeah. It is interesting, though.
It doesn't have the same ring.
No, it doesn't have the same ring. It's interesting, though, that you mentioned, I didn't know that. They didn't even pay for the rights. So you didn't get the Sully, the Sullenberger treatment, where it's like, oh, they're going to make a movie about me and I'm set.
No, nor would I have sold them. Somebody actually did offer me some dough for the rights to my book and my story. And I had no desire to see the story retold or, you know, to be portrayed in any way. I never saw The Loudest Voice. When Bombshell came out, I finally watched that one just because I was like, okay, I guess people are going to talk about this and I better know what happened. Mm. I was not really in that one, which is fine. I learned some things I didn't know about Roger from that one. It was interesting. But I think overall, like, you know, one of my problems with Bombshell was they took these Fox personalities, people who I really like, and made caricatures out of them. You know, yeah, like Brian Kilmeade is a good guy. And they took like little sort of funny snippets between Brian and Gretchen. And Gretchen likes Brian. I know that. I don't know Gretchen, but I know somebody who she's pretty close with. She likes Brian. He had her back a lot of the time on that show. But they take these snippets of them being kind of like inappropriate, avant-garde, whatever.
Right.
And try to make him look like he's just a bastard. You know, he's a prick, he's a sexist prick. And he's not. He's a good guy. So those little things were kind of irritating.
Yeah, it's got to be tough watching. Like, well, that's not right. And plus, you know, I mean, they gave Brian Kilmeade a couple inches in height, though. I think they brought him up to like 5'9". So he's got to be happy about that.